Welcome back to Signalis. Oh boy, sir, it's been a little bit since my last video, and I've done some research, right? Holy shit, how the fuck did anyone find out about this ending? It is so convoluted. Anyways, so I'm going to be playing through this game one final time, and we're going for a secret ending. I have no idea what it is. I have a non-spoiler guide up in the different menu, different tab, and I'll be referring to that as we go. And to be perfectly honest, I'm not sure why I've been making this a video. I just like this game so much. I just feel like it, really. Shall we? I believe the secret steps only begin once we get to the second chapter. So for now, we're back in S23 Sierpinski. I picked this up on my first playthrough. Despite of saying nothing, Ito mentions that tells us that good luck finding whoever we're looking for. So that's one of the first references to place being kind of nuts. Now we head back Gerber to the Rim of Silence. And we input a frequency to 96. Right here. Motionless, like right. Here it is. The key of love. That is our very first key. Next one we will find is a bit later on. Cycle 888. I've tried to teach Elster how to dance. It's so cute and how clumsy she can be when it comes to these things. We're hanging out here too often. Ammo for the pistol when I get back. Sad needing a son. What the fuck? What the? The fuck? Operation. I've never been here before. I must have missed it. Win AOEON guidelines 176 for the deployment of operational procedures, operational psychology. In order to reliably protect the safety of our nation, AON must develop and deploy procedures and technologies to maintain complete control over all replicas in service of the nation. Just like with Gestalts. Procedures involving operational psychology are highly effective for behavior control of replicas. The primary advantage of replicas over gestalts is predictability. All newly deployed replicas of models are virtually identical both physically and psychologically. As they all share the same memories under the same circumstances, a newly developed dual unit will practically always react in the same way. However, as soon as the unit encounters new situations, it will begin to deviate from its original pattern. In some cases, this may lead to a unit being less efficient for its intended purposes. This is called persona degradation. Using a wealth of private information about the life of a gestalt, each neural pattern is based. Allows us to ensure optimal, uniform post-deployment development of each unit. What the fuck? Based on allow us. In simpler terms, our primary objective is a focused manipulation of the individual to ensure they remain as close to the original pattern as possible, thus productive, loyal, and docile for as long as possible. This is called persona stabilization. Stabilization can come in many forms and usually takes on the form of regular activities or fetish objects that distract and calm the replica. Until the development of bioresonance technology that allows wide-scale direct behavior control, the method of operational psychology still remains the most reliable way to control both replicas and gestalts in the interest of protection of national security. Jesus. Fucking running sentence. I didn't find it on my first playthrough. That's cool. Who are you? Oh, it's you. What are you doing here? Aren't you supposed to be down in the mine? Flashlight? Take a look. Right now. Bamboo plants thriving on the growth of light. Can you believe this? All these files. They think they know us so well. So much talk about persona and stabilization. In the end, they just want us to shut up and work until we die. What a joke. What do you mean you don't remember me? You hit your head? I'm staying here. No chance I'm ever going back to work. Weird, dude. Is this meant to be like a fucking... Is this like a new game thing? That is so cool. What the fuck? Discarded hard hats lie among the stacks of classified files. Oh, that's so cool. Damn. Anyways, where were we for this? Not time. Key of Eternity. This is our second key. Chapter 3, Gestaltsterfall. And we're back in Sipinski, looking a bit more shitty than usual. Poor Itao, not having the best time of her life. Couldn't find her. Oh, after 3 hours, I can't really find myself to be that sad. Forgive me. Itao Lilith. Huh. Must be Lilith. Ah, okay. It took me a second playthrough to realize which character we were. Lilith. Now we can complete the puzzle. Yeah, what for our misses and theirs. Ah. Here's the safe. It still is here after all this time. The key of eternity, key of love, and the key of sacrifice. Seems to be insignia of the safe manufacturer. Now, the code. Do you remember the... What was it? The code is the entire... three-note oddity broadcast, like, thing, so... 3-9-4-8-6-6-0-1-7-0-2-4-3-2-6-0-1-0-6-4. Flowers. White lilies. Pick up the flower. Is that the same? What? That's a whole lot of... That's Elsters. It's me with my fucked up chest. Me when I was in the Penrose. What the hell is that? I gotta translate that in German, I guess. Now that you mention it, it does look like an eye. Remember our promise.
Okay. What the fuck?
Wow. I did that for 3 hours. I got that. Okay. That was pretty cool. What the fuck does that mean? Oh, fuck. Made me a little bit teary-eyed. They were roommates. Huh. Well, I'll get my thoughts. I'll skip to my thoughts after this cut, after this credits. I just want to enjoy the music for now. Three, 2 hours, 50 minutes, time saved 11, time floated once, time died once. Killed 104 enemies, shots fired 187 times. Artifact ending. The artifact. Huh. Wow. Oh, that was fun. Oh my god. That was fun, just quickly playing through Signalis, basically all the way. Yeah. That's fucked up. That ending fucked me up. Oh, Jesus. Dude, it's been like 2 weeks since I've played this game, or so. I'm probably right back into my, like, post-game depression. Damn. Fuck, this game is still so good. It's still... obviously one of the best in the signal horror, in the survival horror category. It's up there with Dead Space and Silent Hill. Well, Dead Space more action horror, sorry. It depends on how you look at it. It's up there with the original survival horrors, Resident Evil and Silent Hill. But I honestly think it exceeds them. I think it exceeds the original Resident Evil and Silent Hill 1. Silent Hill 2 is kind of goated. But yeah, Signalis is definitely up there with the greatest of all times. Yeah, so this is it for Signalis on this channel. That's crazy. Signalis brought me back to when I was playing through Amori. Not like in the same category game, but like through the sad as fuck story. Oh man, I butchered the fuck out of my Amori playthrough. I was like 16 when I was uploading that, or 15. Jesus. Anyways. Thank you for coming out. Hope you enjoyed this little... I don't know how long this video is going to be, actually. Probably around half an hour once I finish it all up. And, just like my last episode of Signalis, I've got to leave a little cutscene of, like, you know, my favorite moments of, like, cutscenes all sits together like a little Signalis cutscene. I hope you enjoy it. Leave a like, subscribe, leave a comment, algorithm stuff, all that. I'll see you when I see you then. Farewell.